Okay, so we're back again. So what I'm going to discuss now is creating methods that require a single parameter. But before that, paano natin malalaman kung ano ang parameter? Kailangan muna natin i-discuss kung ano ang arguments. So argument is an information sent from the outside into method. Then implementation hiding, so we call it encapsulation of method details within class. Calling method needs to understand only interface to call method. So include within method declaration parentheses kapag meron tayong parameter, kailangan natin ng parameter type and the local name for the parameter. Ano kaya yun? Okay, so this is the example of a method with single parameter. Okay, so this is the method declaration, public static void predict race. Okay, then this now is the parameter. Okay, meron tayong parameter type, tinatawag din natin siyang data type sa iba. Okay, but in here, parameter type naman. Then parameter identifier or your variable name, dito natin nilalagay. So parang nagde-declare ka ng bagong variable, but as a parameter. Local variables known only within boundaries of methods. Ibig sabihin, pag local variable, ibig sabihin, para kay method lang. Under sa method lang na yun. Hindi natin pwede gamitin sa ibang methods or anything. Then each time method executes, variables are redeclared. Okay, then new memory location large enough to hold typesets up and name. Okay, so later na yan, methods can require more than one parameter. Magbibigay muna ako ng example with a single parameter. Okay, so nakakreate na ako ng file for the single parameter methods. Let's try to create a method na. So for example, let's use the method public static void display sum. Okay? So kapag ganyan, this is zero parameter. Pero kapag meron tayong parameter type sa loob ng display sum na method, for example, int i first. Okay? So this is a single parameter. Okay? So this is the parameter type, then this is the parameter identifier or the variable name. Okay? Then for example, i-display natin si i first. Okay, so paano natin ngayon siya i-execute? Okay, so we call it method calling. So, i-call natin si display sum. Okay. Take note, makikita nyo kapag kinol ko si display sum, okay, meron tayong short error dito. Sabi dito, method display sum in class parameter method cannot be applied to given types. Kasi meron siyang required parameter. Then sabi diyan found no argument. Bakit kaya no argument? Okay, saan nakikita ang argument? Ang argument naman is nakikita sa method calling. 'Di ba ang sabi kanina? Argument are information sent from outside into method. Outside. So outside ako ng display sum, pero ipapasa ko ngayon ang isang data. For example, bibigyan ako ng 100. So 100 is considered integer type or data type. So pinapasa ko ngayon or I'll be sending 100 into our method display sum and may magre-receive na int i first which is integer, okay? So dapat exact 'yan kasi kapag naka-enclose ito ng parent double quotation mark, so meron tayong error because the receiver is integer and the sent data is string. So hindi pwede yan. Dapat compatible silang pareho. Okay? So kapag niran ko ngayon yan, the output would be 100. Nakuha. So pinapasa natin ngayon as argument si data na 100. Then magre-receive si parameter ng int i first. Okay? So take note, huwag kakalimutan kapag mag di-declare kayo ng parameter, kailangan natin ng parameter type and the parameter identifier. Okay? So, for example, maglalagay na ako ngayon dito ng plus 200. Okay? So, kapag nirun ko yan, so 100 plus 200 is 300. Nakuha? Okay. I-create ako ulit ng isa pa. Create ako ulit ng isang method, public static void. Ang ipapasa naman natin is display name. Okay. So, i-display natin daw yung name. For example, magpapasa tayo ng data. So, string str first name. Then, i-output lang natin. And, tapos, name plus str first name. Okay. Then, i-call na natin ngayon si display name. Okay. Take note. Error ulit tayo kasi wala tayong nahanap na argument. So, kailangan ng argument. Okay. There are two ways to send a data as an argument. Either constant value or we can also send a variable or data type. For example, magdi-declare ako ng string strname equals Cardo Alisay. Okay. Either of the two, pwede tayong constant data na ibibigay. So, naka-enclose dapat yan ng parent, double quotation because the data type that will receive it is string. Okay? Or, pwede din tayong directly the str name or the variable name. It is possible also. So, there are two ways to pass an argument or two type na pwede nating ipass as an argument. First is a constant value, which is, for example, 100, or a data variable, like this str name. Okay, so if I run the program, so I call first the display sum, which is the 100. Okay, 100 and 200, pinag-add ko sila. So, 300. Then, I called again the display name, which is the str name yung sinesend natin. And may data siya na Cardo Dalisay. So, mapupunta siya ngayon sa first name or str first name na receiver as parameter. Okay, then i-output lang natin. System.out.println name str Cardo Dalisay. Okay, so if you have any questions with this video, feel free to message me. Okay? Pwedeng-pwede kayong magtanong basta school related.